Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the afternoon session of the opening day today, the 11th of September, 1893. We now introduce you to Swami Vivekananda from India.
Sisters and brothers of America.
Hello, good morning dear children. Welcome to social science class. Dear children, I hope you all have completed your notes of the previous lesson. Right? You have to learn well, okay? Today, we are going to learn the new lesson 11, United Nations. In this lesson, you will learn about the United Nations, the formation of the United Nations, aims of the United Nations, structure of the United Nations, and the special agencies of the United Nations. Now, let us discuss about why was the United Nations formed. Competition between the main European nations for greater power and wealth led to the two world wars. The World War I broke out in 1914 and it ended in 1918, and the World War II broke out in 1939 and it ended in 1945. These wars caused enormous loss of life and property and brought untold misery and suffering to people around the world. The wars were followed by famine, epidemics, and more death. Do you know when was the United Nations Organization formed? On 24th October 1945, the United Nations Organization came to exist. It was formed with 51 member countries. The Charter of the UN was drawn up and signed by the members. What do you mean by the word charter? Which means a set of rules. Now, the United Nations has 193 member countries. Dear children, will you be able to say when do we celebrate UN Day or United Nations Day? Yes, United Nations Day or UN Day is celebrated every year on 24th October, isn't it? Now, let us discuss about the aims of the United Nations or UN. The aims of the UN committed to maintaining peace and security around the world. The main aim of the United Nations is to prevent war, developing friendly relations among countries, promoting social progress, better living standards, and human rights. So, what do you mean by the word human rights? Which means the basic rights every human being is entitled to regardless of sex, race, religion, language, and nationality. Protecting the environment, increasing food production, and disaster management. Then the last, curbing terrorism. So what do you mean by the word curbing? Which means something that limits or restrains. Look at this picture. In this picture, you could see the flag of the United Nations. The UN works towards the peace and security of the people of the world as represented by the world map at the center of the flag. The olive branches represent peace in the world. Is it clear? Next, we can discuss about the structure of the UN. The United Nations functions mainly through six organs or bodies. They are the General Assembly, the Security Council, the Secretariat, the Economic and Social Council, the Trusteeship Council, the International Court of Justice. These are the six organs of the UN. Today, we can discuss about the first two organs of the UN. Okay? Now, we can discuss about the first organ or body of the UN, that is the General Assembly. This is the main organ of the UN. It is made up of all 193 member countries. Each country has one vote. It meets every year. Discussions on all actions of the UN are held in the General Assembly. Every member country can put forward its ideas and opinions. So, in the United Nations, the small or poor countries have the same voice and power as the big or rich countries. Based on the discussions, decisions are taken on what actions should be taken. Dear children, now can you say which is the main organ of the UN? Yes, the General Assembly. Is it clear, all of you? Next, we can move on with the second organ or body of the UN, that is the Security Council. The Security Council is the most powerful organ of the UN. It is responsible for maintaining international peace and security. It has 15 members. 5 of them are permanent members. These are the United States of America, the United Kingdom, France, Russia, and China. These members have the power to veto or overrule any resolution taken by the General Assembly. The other 10 members are elected each for 2 years. Its decisions are binding on all the member states of the UN. Dear children, what do you mean by the word veto? Which means the power to reject a decision taken by the others in the group. Did you understand? Okay, dear children, two organs of the UN we studied now. The rest of the organs of the UN we will discuss in the next class. Okay, now I am concluding today's class. But before that, let us summarize what we discussed. We discussed about the formation of the United Nations. On 24th October 1945, the United Nations organization came to exist. And UN Day is celebrated every year on 24th October. The main aim of the UN is committed to maintaining peace and security around the world. Next, we discussed about the first two organs of the UN. They are the General Assembly and the Security Council. I hope you all have understood these topics. Everyone should read the lesson. Okay? Thank you and have a nice day.